I ate more candy on that set.
You did.
Right?
You did a lot of candy, yes. Every scene required Kevin to bite into something good.
And what was horrible, as much as I ate all day, they would catch me off camera, like when we weren't shooting, they'd be like, we're not rolling anymore. And I was like, oh, no, I know, I was just getting ready for this thing.
Kevin used to, but they'd bring the spit bucket over to Kevin and he would wave them off.
I would put my head in the spit bucket like I'm going to get rid of it, and then I'd come back up with it and they'd go, it's empty. I don't know what to do with this thing.
So I got a chance to see the movie, Huey Halloween. It's hilarious. How great is it just to be able to work with somebody who you're so comfortable with as much as you guys have?
It's a pain in the ass for me every time, but Adam, it's a joy for you. You want to tell him?
It's got, I talk him into it. I say, you know, they're going to give you money. He says no. Then I say, they're going to give you, a new motorcycle. He says, not yet. And then I say, they have these incredible dumplings. He goes, ooh.
Oh, that's, you've sparked my interest.
Yeah, no, we loved being together. It's just like, I'm sure you with the right guys and you get excited to hang out with your buddies, the same thing.
It's the greatest. You got all the people you're familiar with, and then this cool, crazy guest that pop in.
Yeah.
Like in this movie, we got some sick people coming in, and it's an event.
We talk to the same people so much that when a new cast member comes in the movie, we're so excited to talk to another human being.
Yeah.
Especially now in 2020.
Yeah. Right. Yes.
Could you give a little bit of insight to the film? I would talk about it, but I don't want to give away too much.
It's Kevin James and I went to high school together in the movie. He became a policeman.
Kind of a chief, right? I think you're forgetting.
Well, yeah, he's up there. He has a high rank. I considered you Sarge. Yeah, not but I'm a little goofy, but I take Halloween very serious, and I want it to go smoothly for the community of Salem, Massachusetts. And I see things. I report them to Kevin. Kevin doesn't really care much of what I have to say, but this particular year, some stuff's going on.
Yeah,
they need old Hubie.
Yeah, a little bit of the boy who cried wolf. It's a guy who just complains every year, same stuff, constantly calling the office, bothering me. And, when you say you can't say yes, you just got to cut them off. And then something happens. Someone grabs you by the shorties.
By the shorties.
I mean, there's a lot of holidays and a lot of holiday movies. And we were all like, there hasn't been too many yet. Halloween movie. So we were all jumped in and tried to come up with a lot of stuff that we thought would be fun.
Is that kind of just what sparked the idea in general, just trying to figure out a way to get a Halloween movie going? Or was there something with this character that you wanted to push him into?
Me and Kevin, we like playing goofy guys. This was a type of guy that Tim Hurley, he wrote the script. We always like this type of guy, just extra goofy, you know.
You love him, too. You're rooting for him the whole way, man.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You can't help but root for a guy who's beaten on throughout an entire movie. He does take...
And eats more soup than any human ever.
Yeah, he loves soup. You know that, Xavier. I'm sure you like soup, too.
It's delicious. It's probably the best thing you can eat. So I really connected with him on that level. You know, the fact that I won't give too much information again. The thermos.
I think that's one of the main themes of the movie is how many people realize at that moment, because soup is something that's always in your life. And you go, how great is soup? It makes you say, how great is soup? And you think about that and you go home.
These are the philosophical questions that I was asking myself once the credits started rolling. Yeah. I was like, man, do I want some clam chowder right now?
You should, Xavier.
But to kind of go into, Happy Madison production. So you started up in 99 and you've just been cranking out movies since. Is this something that you knew that you wanted to do once you started in the industry, or something that kind of evolved over time?
No, didn't want to do that too much. Just wanted to make movies. And then all my friends wanted to make movies. So that comedian friends. So I guess that's how it got, that's why it continues. Just to make sure that we're all getting to do what we want to do, comedy-wise.
Well, it's an absolute blast to watch. And Kevin, like we were talking about your character, Officer Steve Downing. You seem like you really leaned into that and had a lot of fun playing.
It was the best. It was an incredible character that was it's different than anything I've ever done. And he was fun, and he had a massive beard, which they would never let at the Salem Police Department, right? No. But I think that's the rank I had, that I could grow that full beard and be like that and have fun. I ate more candy on that set.
You did.
Right?
He did a lot of candy, yes. Every scene required Kevin to bite into something good.
And what was horrible, as much as I ate all day, they would catch me off camera, like when we weren't shooting, they'd be like, "We're not rolling anymore." And I was like, "Oh, no, I know. I was just getting ready for this thing."
Kevin used to, but they'd bring the spit bucket over to Kevin and he would wave them off.
I would put my head in the spit bucket like I'm going to get rid of it. And then I'd come back up with it and they'd go, "It's empty. I don't know what to do with this thing every time."
That's what I was thinking, because like obviously on a set, you know, you've got prop things. Like, oh, maybe they got like some prop candies because they got to use them every time they're on the camera.
That was an amazing thing. They because of they have access to this. They had candies from every year growing up.
Kevin, you never had a payday before.
What?
This, right?
No.
You never, and then
no.
He had it during the scene. He was like, "Oh my god!"
It was amazing. It was amazing. The amount of candy that I had, and that was one. I was worried about it because I had to eat so much of it, and that was one of the ones they caught me off by a tree eating.
Speaking on Halloween stuff, do you guys have any wild Halloween memories from your childhoods that may have played into this movie, or if they didn't, just some good stories?
I was dressed up as a little boy. I would do it. And then my later stages, I was with the guys. We were bad. We were
all right. We got in trouble. We got in trouble.
Yeah.
We got in trouble in my town. I don't remember the whole story, but we were a little older to be trick-or-treating. And I think I didn't realize we were going out to terrorize the town. I was still dressed up with as a robot or something. But I think we were egging cars or something like that. And we got caught. And I think there was like 9 of us, and they brought us all down to jail. I think that's a true story. I might have made that up, but I think that's true.
Yeah, mine was completely made up. You really did that?
I don't know. I gotta ask my friends if that really happened.
It's a criminal. I gotta go back and check into that because you could be in trouble, Sam.
No, they let us off the hook. Said no more of that next year.
But if you were arrested, that should be on the record. You're probably on the record.
No record. We didn't go inside the holding cell. They kept us by the bench.
It doesn't matter. Once they write the thing, I'm going to have to look at. Can you look into that, please?
Check the fingerprints. Well, geez, guys, the movie was incredible. And I really love all of the attention to detail and how mean people can really be to someone.
Yes. We found a lot of different ways to come at Hubie. And even when he was doing nice things, people didn't seem to. He saved a woman's cat. Saves a woman's cat, and she's still nasty to him.
Yeah.
Not nice.
I was just waiting for somebody to be like, "Oh, man, what a great guy."
Not... about you, Xavier? Are you going to – what is the dream? We're going to do wrestling, and then what are we moving on to after wrestling? Well, we're staying in wrestling our whole life. Anyway, it's good with me.
So I have a master's degree in child psychology, so I want to work with children who are dealing with autism. I'm very close to a PhD, but wow. I want to work in video games, and that's kind of like where my path is currently.
Creating video games?
Yeah, creating, writing scripts for video games, writing out full stories for them. I've done a little bit here and there, but also I do like acting, and I do like scary movies. I like Halloween. Yeah. You know, if you need somebody to get tossed around a little bit.
You certainly belong in a good movie. You seem cool as hell, buddy.
Yeah.
Well, I appreciate it, guys. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate this. And honestly, I look up to both of you. You guys are huge inspirations. Your comedic timing is absolutely impeccable. Kevin, your dance moves in Hitch. Oh my God, I love. Adam, if we could get a prequel to the Zohan, I would lose my mind.
Yes, that's a good idea.
But that's the best Gabe Sandman I've ever seen, too.
Bro, he was so nasty. But again, appreciate your time. And thank you so much. And good luck with the movie Hubie Halloween. Check it out.